Welcome to Dental and Ayurveda, a channel for basic dental sciences and Ayurvedic sciences. Our today's chapter is Chemotherapy of Malaria, a chapter of Pharmacology.
So today we are going to study about Chemotherapy of Malaria. So this malaria is caused by protozoa of genus Plasmodium and it is transmitted in human body due to bite of female Anopheles mosquito. So, you know, from blood it is carried to liver and then it multiplies in the liver cells and then in RBCs. And on maturation in RBCs, they are going to rupture and cause symptoms of malaria. So, the male and female, both the sexual forms, they enter the mosquito when they suck blood and undergo the sexual cycle. So, the first we are going to talk about the classifications of anti-malarial drugs. So, the first classification that I'm going to talk about is casual prophylactics, primaquine and pyrimethamine. So these are going to destroy the tissue forms of parasite and liver cells and they're going to prevent invasion of erythrocytes. They are also known as tissue schizonticides. Then comes your blood schizonticides. These are chloroquine, quinine, mefloquine, halofantadine and pyrimethamine. So these are suppressives. They are going to destroy the parasites in RBCs and terminate the clinical attack. Okay, then, so obviously as they are terminating the clinical attack, they act as a suppressive also. So then we have tissue schizonticides which are used to prevent relapse. So under this comes your primaquine. So it is going to act on the hepatic forms of Plasmodium vivax and Plasmodium ovale. So that these are going to produce the relapse. So, and the blood schizonticides, they are given, they bring the radical cure and they eradicate the parasite from the body. Then we are going to talk about some of the gametocidal drugs also. Under this comes your primaquine, chloroquine and quinine. So these three drugs, you know, gametocidal drugs, they are going to destroy the gametocytes and they're going to prevent the transmission of malaria. So also preventing the transmission of malaria. Then we are going to talk about a drug for malaria, that is chloroquine. So chloroquine, it is a synthetic, you know, 4-aminoquinolone and it completely cures the falciparum malaria. And you know, in pregnancy it is very safely given and also has anti-inflammatory properties. Then you can say that this drug, you know, the mechanism of action of this drug is not very clear and it is highly effective blood schizonticide against all the 4 species of Plasmodium. So against all the 4 species it is very effective. Then I'm going to talk about the adverse effects of this particular drug. So these are very common adverse effects, that nausea, vomiting, headache, visual disturbances, all this, which is very common. Okay, then you have irreversible retinopathy. It may occur if the treatment is prolonged with high doses, and high doses can also cause cardiomyopathy or some psychiatric problems as well. Then this is the uses of malaria. So this is the dosage form. Then it is also used in extra intestinal amoebiasis, rheumatoid arthritis, lepra reactions, then also in photogenic reactions. Then the other drug that we are going to talk about is quinine. So basically this is a natural, you know, drug. This is alkaloid which is obtained from the bark of cinchona tree. So what are the important actions of this drug is that it is very effective. Okay, it is a very effective suppressive. Then, you know, it is a mild analgesic and mild antipyretic as well. And it is effective gametocidal drug. Then it acts as a myocardial depressant and the local anesthetic and skeletal muscle relaxant. So this is also used like that. Now adverse effects, when I will talk about, that these, you know, adverse effects of this particular drugs are somewhat high. Like this is common, like nausea, vomiting, epigastric pain. This is common, but Synchronism also occurs, like ringing in ears, headache, nausea, like that. So quinine poisoning is also one of the adverse effects. In this, you know, fever, confusion, cardiac arrhythmias, all this can occur. So what are the uses? That it is resistant falciparum malaria, and cerebral malaria. Maybe we can use here also. And nocturnal muscle cramps. Then we have mefloquin. So this is highly effective in a single dose only. And adverse effects, you can see those common: nausea, vomiting, dizziness. And uses, that it is, you know, presently it is only indicated in MDR strains of Plasmodium falciparum. Now we are going to talk about sulfadoxin. So it is a very effective suppressive in all the four species of Plasmodia, and it is also given with sulfadoxin. Like, this combination is synergistic and the development of resistance is also slower. So it is going to act by inhibiting the folic acid synthesis. So uses, you can see that it is used as an alternative to chloroquine along with quinine also.
Our ready to read notes are available on our Instagram page.